Hey guys, welcome back for the weekly updates. And I'm gonna start very quick with Bitcoin. This is the BTC USD 1 week candles. And we are lower than we were on my last video 1 week ago. And the week just closed. This last candle just closed. And we can see that it clearly closed below the 50 week moving average, which is the blue moving average, which I talked on the which I talked about on my last video and many times in the past, because it's usually a very strong support, and not just for Bitcoin but for like any asset really. It serves as a strong support. It had many touches in the past, and when the price goes below it, it becomes resistance, and it's actually usually a very accurate resistance. And once it breaks above it again, then we go into the into another bull market. It happened here also in the very first bubble here. So there was a bubble, and then it was support, and then once it broke below it, it was full bull market, full bear market. And then it was resistance here, and once it breaks above it, it goes into a full-on bull market again. Now the price went below the 50-week moving average, which is significant. But I still actually someone asked on the private Telegram groups what was the probability that we go into a full bear market from here. And my answer was, from my perspective, it's very low, because the four moving average on the weekly chart are up, all of them are uptrending, and all of them are in sequence. Even the 20 week moving average, which is the first one, the red one, which is the smallest one, it's starting to go flat, but it's not even flat. I mean, this high here, it's higher than the previous one, so it's still uptrending. All four moving averages are uptrending, and they're in sequence, and that's basically the definition of a bull market. So if we're in a very clear bull market, there's no reason to predict a full bear market from here. There's just no reason. Like, I mean, it's in a very clear uptrend. The price generally is in a very very nice uptrend here, but for the short term, short to medium term, actually, because these are the weekly candles, so anything here is going to take some time to happen, you know, for the candles to develop. So for the short to medium term, we are kind of bearish, like bearish, neutral, leaning to bearish for the short to medium term. We do have a target in the downside, but I'm not going to be sharing all the information here that I share for private members. But we do, for the short to medium term, this chart doesn't look that bullish, but generally we're in a very nice uptrend here. And so if we look at the daily, and I set it here to see a 1 year, there's absolutely nothing else to read here other than what I said already on the weekly, because for 1 year, this is a whole year, it's just been going up and down and up, and now it's going down. So it's going sideways generally, with of course a lot of opportunity for trading, but yes, it's just nothing new to say here other than what I said already on the weekly. So for Bitcoin, neutral, leaning to bearish for the short to medium term. Now I'm going to look at Ethereum very quick here, and that's just a complete different picture. This chart looks extremely bullish, and I have been looking at other, you know, main altcoins, and they all look way more bullish than Bitcoin. So what I'm expecting is that Bitcoin might continue to go sideways for some time when altcoins are uptrending, because I mean Ethereum here just broke the previous all-time high, which was at 1500. It broke here, I mean, not that recently, actually almost 1 year ago, but because these are the weekly candles, but it already went up and retested that top, and it held and it went up, and it seems like here since March 2020 it's been in this super nice uptrend here. So, and now the price is touching right, you know, it's approaching or right at the trend line here. So I would expect a bounce here. I would expect a bounce. It did touch the 50-week moving average. Bitcoin broke below it, and Ethereum, so far it's holding, and it's also the same level with this trend line. So I expect I expect Ethereum versus USD to bounce or maybe just stay here, you know, around the trend line here for a few candles, which would be a few weeks because these are the weekly candles. But I expect altcoins, Ethereum more specifically, and now that I'm doing Ethereum, I expect them to bounce sometime soon, bounce on this trend line and continue the uptrend. Now, if it breaks below it, then the next, if it breaks below this trend line, like clearly breaking and closing below it, and it starts to close below it, then yes, the next support would be the 100 week moving average, which is the yellow moving average. And I cannot say a price because the moving average is uptrending. So by the time this happens, if it happens, the price would be somewhere, you know, up here, which I can't, you know, there's just no way I would know that. It depends how long it takes. And so I cannot say a specific price, but just wherever the 100 week moving average is, I would see that as a good buying opportunity for Ethereum for sure. Because like I said, it's in a very, very nice uptrend here. If we look at the daily, let's see the last 1 year. So it just went below every moving average actually. So it's like going flat on the weekly, on the daily candles, I'm sorry. So yes, for the daily, more neutral than for the weekly, but it's still bullish and it's still time to bounce here on the trend line, and it will probably find resistance where all the moving averages are around almost $4,000, around $4,000. It seems to be strong. Strong resistance. So okay, my call or my prediction is that it'll be stuck at around 4,000 for quite some time here until it does bounce and break the all-time highs. And when it does break the all-time highs, then we'll take it from there and we will be able to get some targets. Let's see, the all-time high was at 4,600. So that was all for the weekly updates. Guys, check the description and the pinned comments if you're interested in free education. I have a new website now. You can find free courses and tutorials from there. And if you want to join the private groups, you will find the links down below as well. So thank you very much for watching. See you next week. Bye.